Yeah, hey, what's up, Justin? I just saw your question on the Facebook page, and I have a lot to say about it, so I'm just going to shoot this quick video while I'm driving home from somewhere. So, manipulating the weight transfer on a front-wheel drive car is really interesting stuff because there's just so much weight sitting over the front axle, right? So, one of the problems that people tend to have when they're trying to get their front-wheel drive to rotate is that they go so heavy on the brakes, you know, to maximize their efficiency in the braking zone, and when they turn in, they're not letting the brakes off at all, because especially in a front-wheel drive car, you can't turn and brake at 100% at the same time. The tire's not physically capable of it. So since the front end is already so heavy and you overload it by going into the corner, you start turning in while you're at full braking capacity, the car is not going to bite. The front end's going to go away, you're going to understeer, and you will never get your car to rotate if you can't get initial front end bite, because that's what causes the rear. There's two things that causes the rear end of a car to rotate. The first one is that the front end has to have enough grip to start into the corner, and the rear has to have enough weight removed from it so that it can start to slide out. And front wheel drives are really tricky like that, so I would say, if you're having trouble with that, I would start braking a little sooner with a little less intensity. And then as I was turning the wheel in, I would let the brakes out a little bit. So, for example, if your turn-in percentage is like 20% of this total steering ability, then I would bring the brake pressure back to 80%. And that makes 100% of grip. Cars can't exceed 100%. That doesn't make any sense. So if you're turning at 50%, then you can only brake at 50%. If you're turning at 70%, you can only brake at 30%. It has to add up to 100. So people tend to overload the front end of a front-wheel drive car because it's already heavy, and it's way heavier during the braking zone. So you have to come off the brakes. It's counterintuitive, but you have to come off the brakes when you start turning in, or you won't get that initial bite. And if you can't get that front end turn-in bite, then the rear's not going to rotate. So I would try that. That's what I would try. As far as corner exit goes, I have a lot to say about this too. I was talking to Tom O'Gorman a few weeks ago, and he is last year's Pirelli World Challenge champion in the TCB class, and he's an expert at driving front-wheel drive cars. And he said one of the things he learned right away was that in a front-wheel drive car, when you're starting to get back on the throttle, it's really tempting to go too hard too fast. And especially with a car that has an open differential where the inside tire can spin, because the weight transfer has shifted to the outside of the corner, it makes the inside tire light, and that's what makes it spin. And a lot of people are like, okay, well, that's fine. It'll work. It'll just, you know, wear that tire out faster. Well, you have to consider, it's not all about tire wear. Sometimes it is, depending on the length of the race. But the thing you really want to consider is that once that tire starts spinning and you're not controlling the throttle, you're just pounding on it, pouncing on the throttle, once that tire starts spinning, it generates a lot of heat because it is spinning around and around on the driving surface, right? So the problem with that is that once it starts generating more and more heat, it will eventually create so much heat that it leaves its optimal temperature, tire temperature. And once the tire is outside of its optimal temperature range, then the tire doesn't have enough grip. So once you get, say it's a left-hand sweeping corner, and you spin the inside tire all the way through it, once you get to the next right-hand corner, your outside load-bearing tire isn't going to have any grip at all because it's so hot. So it's not all about wearing the tire out, but the trick in exiting a corner on a front-wheel drive car, according to Tom O'Gorman, who's the expert, like I said, PWC champion, is to be really patient on the throttle and really learn throttle modulation. You know, you don't have to make just one input at the beginning of a corner, okay? You can change it. You can come off the throttle a little. You can add throttle. You can make adjustments to maximize the car's potential, but you've got to be very aware of adding too much throttle too soon because you don't want to get that inside wheel spin. So that's what I would say. So just a quick recap. So to get the car to rotate better, you need to manipulate the car's weight more efficiently, and that means you simply have to make sure the front end doesn't get overloaded. So like I said, use your percentages. If your turning percentage is 20, you can only brake at 80 when you're turning, okay? So in a corner exit speed, I would just highly recommend learning throttle modulation and not spinning the inside wheel. That's probably the two biggest tips I'd say about driving a front-wheel drive car. Right on, my man. We'll talk to you soon.